flowing from second calendrian year. So from this pipeline it is flowing to this second calendrian. Again, just like the first evaporator, in the second calendrian we are having a riser at the center. From there the milk will be rising to the top and then getting distributed to the milk distribution plate. Again, this is a, also a selective type of milk exchanger. On the tube side, we will be having a partially condensed milk sac from the evaporator one, and on the shelf side, we will be having the vapor coming from the vapor separator one. So here we can see from vapor separator one, the 159 is going to the shelf side of the second calendria. So in the shelf side of second calendria, we will be using heating media, vapor of the calendria, and on the product side, we will be having partially condensed milk coming from the first calendria itself. So both shelf and tube side, these are coming from the calendria one. So here you can see at the top of the first vapor separator, we are having a junction which is connected with four pipelines. So both four pipelines, one pipeline which is seeming to be of mild steel, a little bit, we can say, the ground connect pipeline that is made steel line which is flowing at the nozzle of the DPR. It will be sucking the vapor from calendria 1 and compressing it. So, DPR is compressing the vapor and then sending that compressed vapor to calendria 2. That will be partially sending the same compressed vapor to calendria 1 and 2. So, this DPR is supplying a steam and vapor mixture which is at the required temperature and pressure to be used for heating medium of calendria 1 and calendria 2. So if the calendria 2 part and calendria 1 part, we can also see that designing both calendria, we are having 3 heaters. So both 3 heaters are also connected to the vapor side or the shell side of the calendria. So vapor from both calendria will be used to preheat the milk. It is sequentially coming from heater 3 then 2 to 1. So it will be eventually slowly increasing in temperature before reaching to the final heater to get the heat load at the final steam pressure. Every time the steam pressure is about to heat the fire, generally slow and can be boosted to the heat pressure gauge. The efficiency of this pressure gauge are less. So, when the steam pressure is low, it can be controlled every time. So, here we can see that after calendria 2, the milk partially condensed milk from vapor separator 2 and calendria 2 will be merged together and sent to the second transfer pump. So, in the second transfer pump from the discharge end, we can see this transfer pipeline is connecting this calendria 2 to calendria 3 via this pipeline. So this pipeline can be used as a transfer pipeline for calendria 3. So this is calendria 3. Also in this calendria 3, again similar construction will be there. A riser is at the center. Milk will go to the top, go to the milk distribution section, then fall through the tube, and on the vapor side, on the shelf side, at the heating media, we will be using vapor coming from this vapor separator 2 as a heating. After that, the milk will be coming down along with the vapor. From this vapor separator, vapor will be separated, and whatever condensed milk is there along with vapor will be coming through this pipeline, and condensed milk from the vapor will be connected to this pipeline, both mixing all together, and finally, via product transfer pump, using this pipeline, it will be then sent to either the final product pump station, or it can be using this three-way valve sent back to the initial control, flow control balance tank. So, depending on what is the concentration, whether it has achieved the required level or not, it can be recirculated back to the flow control balance tank, or it can be sent via this PHT. So, we are having a final PHT here. So this PHC will be used to kill or cool the condensed milk coming from the evaporator. is the condensed milk if it is not to be used immediately for drying or other purposes, it requires to be chilled. So it will be chilled by using this CND, so it will be acting as a chiller and then it can be stored into the insulated tank. Otherwise, this pipeline can be directly by using the chiller connected to either a spray dryer or a chiller dryer as that can require. Now, coming on to the vacuum producing section of this evaporator, here we can see after this third calendria, after this third vapor separator, the pipeline is going towards the roof. It is going above the roof even. So, at the above section, above the roof, we are having a condenser. So, that condenser is a barometric condenser, and that barometric condenser will be connected to cooling tower which is located outside the door, and that barometric condenser is having a barometric bag. So this is the bag. So this is the barometric bag of the condenser which is coming from the roof. So here we can see that barometric bag is leading to our tank. So this is a water tank in which the condensate of the milk vapor, which is in the form of water vapor only, from the milk will be collected in this tank so that the vacuum does not break, and by using this transfer pump, it will be transferred to the cooling tower. So the cooling tower will be used for cooling of this condensate and supplying it back to the condenser. And this is the steam condensate collector system. So here we can see that this piece of heating mat is connected to the shell side of all of the calendrias sequentially. So at the shell side, whatever is the condensate of steam or milk vapor will be coming to this condensate collection device, and finally using this pump it will be collected and will be sent back to the boiler for production of the steam, because it is distilled water from this form of steam which is producing it by using this NRV here. So we are having a NRV in line, so this is non-return bar, so it will be just acting to the forward direction and it will not let it come back. Now coming on to the pump side, on the pump side we can see that this kind of mechanism is placed above each of the pump. So this mechanism is for cooling. So here at the pump side we can see that there is two flexible pipelines connecting onto the bearing side. So this bearing has to be water cooled. So this water is coming from the cooling tower only, and it will be used to cool the bearing of the pump using this connection. So cooled water from the cooling tower will be coming to the bearing, and a return line is going back to this side, and it will be sent back to the cooling tower for recirculation.
Students, this is the condenser of our three-stage evaporator. So here we can see that this particular pipeline, this is coming from the calendria 3 of the evaporator. So it will be carrying the vapors from the milk coming out from the last calendria. So these vapors will be entering to this direct mixing type of condenser. In this condenser we can see there are total 4 pipeline connection. So this is the pipeline connection of the vapors coming from the calendria. At the top we can see one of the pipeline which is coming from the cooling tower and carrying cold water. So it would be near to ambient temperature 30-35 degrees Celsius or so. And here in this vapor duct we will be having vapors coming at around 60 degrees Celsius, 55 degrees Celsius or so temperature, and it will be directly mixing in just like the shower. So there will be shower of a cold water inside this condenser, and it will be directly mixing with this vapor stream coming in. So what will happen due to this direct mixing of cold and hot streams, there will be condensation of these vapors coming from this vapor duct, and both will be forming a single condensate stream and collected at this bottom part of the condenser. So this condenser at the bottom is connected to that collection trough at the ground floor, which I showed you. So this is the pipe or connection which is known as barometric lag. So the length of this barometric lag is required to be at least 10.33 meters to maintain a vacuum of near about 1 atmospheric pressure. This particular pipeline is going to the vacuum pump. So this pipeline will be connected to vacuum pump, which will be sucking the non-condensable gases, if any, which are either leaking into the system or already present in the milk, which is going to the evaporation system. So this will be maintaining the vacuum to the evaporator, and condenser itself will be creating the vacuum to the whole evaporator system.
So actually the water line, whatever is coming from the cooling tower, it is coming from the top and falling on this hot line of steam at around 60 to 65 degrees centigrade in the form of shower. So this steam will be converted into the condensate, and condensation will occur and we will get the water into this pipeline. So this will be coming out at around 40 to 45 degrees centigrade, since this water coming from the top has temperature of about 20 to 30 degrees centigrade, and this is having temperature of around 60 to 65 degrees centigrade. Thank you. So this, in this way the condensation of steam takes place, and condenser works on this principle. And we can see here the cooling tower, from which the cold air of about 20 to 25 degrees centigrade is being supplied from that line. So this is the line of cold water coming from that cooling tower to this condenser. So in this way condensation takes place, and we are maintaining the vacuum inside the whole evaporator system. We maintain the vacuum through this condensation system. Thank you.